Hi guys.
Hang on, let me sort my hair out. We're not very well.
We're not well.
This one's done a 5-hour course. How you did that feeling the way we could? Do you not feel well either? Loads of people don't feel well.
Super cold.
Ask them. We just moaned about ourselves without asking them.
Well, yeah, sorry. This trailer, we need to react to because we watched the teaser together not that long ago and we got an almighty reaction from it. And it's for a, thriller. We're not exactly thriller. I'm not a big fan of the thriller for the sake of the thrillers. Why do you like thrillers?
I like reading thrillers.
Yeah, I just find...
Because I like trying to work out what's going to happen. It has to feel real to me.
If I like a thriller, it has to have an element of humour. For example, I mean, James Bond...
Humour? In your thriller?
Yeah.
Why?
James Bond is a quintessential thriller, isn't it?
Okay, so...
And I really enjoyed it, so I'm saying that's kind of against type for me.
No, I don't see James Bond as a quintessential thriller.
Oh, I do.
I see it as a quintessential...
You're thrilled. You're on the edge of your seat.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's...
Maybe I don't like thrillers. What's a thriller? What's the definition of a thriller, apart from James Bond?
Something that has you on the edge of your seat, usually involves cops, robbers, criminality, and stuff like that.
I don't really want to be on the edge of my seat, but I want to be working things out. Like, for instance, the other day...
Killing Eve.
Killing Eve is the thriller. Made, that series we're watching at the moment, I'd call that
I wouldn't, I'd call that a social commentary. My worry with thrillers is that it involves lots of big guns and lots of fast cars. Car chase.
You see, I call that a blockbuster.
Helicopter. Well, God, we're really splitting hairs
aren't we? Because I'm worried.
I'm trying to work out what...
around with
our genres. As soon as you home in on any genre, wouldn't you agree, film lovers, it kind of starts to fall apart immediately because every single film that's worth of any note breaks genre rules.
I suppose I think of psychological thrillers.
That's
crime
completely
thrillers.
Different. That's Silence of the Lambs.
Yeah, that's a thriller.
That's not a thriller.
What's that?
That's a psychological thriller.
Oh, okay. I don't like thrillers. I like psychological thrillers. I didn't know that. I didn't know James Bond was a thriller.
This is a...
And you're right. It is thrilling when it's good. When What's-His-Face isn't in it.
Is this thrilling?
What's his name?
Is this conversation...
What's his name?
Daniel Craig.
Daniel.
Or as you call him, the wanker. It's not very nice, is it?
He wanted to go. He's done nothing but moan since he first started as Bond.
When he was asked what advice he'd give. Well, I have to say, go and check out my review of No Time to Die. I was blown away by it, quite literally.
I do want to watch it because I love a good Bond, but I refused to go.
It's because you like a thriller.
I hate it.
It's because you like a thriller.
But then it was good, which is good for the film industry, but annoying because I don't want him to be good.
But it's because you like thrillers, you just don't realise.
His head's so big he can't get through the door.
It's not actually, his head's getting smaller.
No, but you know what I mean.
Of course. Okay, well this is a comedy thriller. Just to confuse things even more.
I don't want a comedy thriller.
Why not?
I don't want comedy in my thriller. Give me an example of a comedy thriller.
Comedy thriller.
Let me see if I like comedy thriller. Game Night.
Yeah, that's a comedy thriller.
That's a comedy thriller. Because
you don't know what's going on. That's a good. A tag comedy thriller.
Love that.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, I like comedy thriller.
Okay, well, this is a comedy thriller. Okay, well, this stars Gal Gadot, who's the actress who plays Wonder Woman.
Oh.
Ryan Reynolds.
Oh.
Who you love.
We saw this.
And we saw the teaser. And Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Who we love with every fibre of our being, and we want him to come and live with us.
I want to buff his head and then lick it.
I want him to help me with things that you won't lift.
What are you going to say there?
I want him to put stuff in the attic for me.
Well, he could. He could throw it up there.
Yeah, really. Exactly.
Mind you, if he went in the attic, our house would fall down.
What I'm actually going to do about getting that stuff up into the attic?
Just ask me next time I go upstairs. I don't know what needs to go.
Every time I ask...
Guys, come on. You're here for the cinema.
If you're watching this, could you come around and help me with my attic?
What? This is... Yeah, this is... Now, rumour has it, this is the most expensive individual film Netflix have paid for. So there you go. It's a heist. It's a thriller. It's full of criminality, it's full of comedy. Let's check it out. Let's check it out with sound.
Yeah, let's.
Let's make sure the sound's turned up, Nabs.
Okay, love.
Nolan Booth. The second most wanted art thief in the world. Special Agent John Hartley. FBI.
I'm ready to play.
Hi, guys. How'd you find me?
You saw William Strang's lady with the red hat from the tape.
You can't prove that was me. I got that on Etsy.
I want you to help me catch the most wanted art thief in the world, the Bishop.
Hello, boys. It's so nice to finally meet you in person.
She set me up, framed me.
A few clever keystrokes and... Bye-bye, Agent John Hartley.
She's gonna steal Cleopatra's eggs. They're priceless. If we catch her together, I can clear my name, and I'll help you become the number one thief in the world again.
Lift your neck. Even if I did partner up with you, you still only have one brain.
What's the plan, son of a...
See? Easy peasy.
You have to be the two dumbest men on the planet.
You look awful.
How's it going with your fucking and crime?
5 second rule. This is a marriage of convenience. Come on, divorce without keeping the kids.
Are you kidding me?
What? This is hard! Only
wish to breed, I spoke to a million seeds. Y'all remember me. Trying to beat me.
That's the idea. Bless me, but never ask me to live a lie. In my phone, cause I wanna get
it on till I die. Are you not?
Here's my last thing you should know. Trusting a thief can be dangerous.
Oh, what the fuck?
Exquisitely beautiful, isn't she?
Gal Gadot.
She looks a bit like my cousin Laura.
Yeah, who was in a film, I
think. Certain shots.
Yeah. Mm. It's like looking at, yeah. I didn't think that was as funny as the teaser.
No.
No.
I'm going to be honest. Yeah. It wasn't content rich.
What do you mean by that, babe?
There wasn't a lot of content in it.
No, there was nothing in it. It was a lot. I tell you what that was appealing to. That was appealing to the action thriller.
We loved them. So we laughed where we were being told to laugh. But if you actually look into the script of it, but I'm going to enjoy it anyway.
Yeah, but the last teaser, was great.
I just love their energy.
Yes.
I love their chemistry.
Yes. I love their biology.
I love the biology.
I love their physicality.
Yeah, but it wasn't a content rich. Sorry, just hiccuping. It wasn't content rich.
Yeah, what I'm going to say is the previous teaser appealed to the comedy thriller fan. This appealed to the action thriller fan. And if there's anything else, there's no other type of thriller to appeal.
What were your favourite lines? My work. Use your neck.
Lift from the neck.
I'm taking the kids. And you look awful.
Yeah, they're great. They're brilliant. But there were about 6 zillion brilliant lines in the first teaser. But I'm still seeing it.
For more film and family fun, don't forget to click the subscribe button and make sure to click the bell to never miss an update.